Hello, Madamina, good afternoon, how are you, Miriam?
Hi, teacher, I'm fine, and you?
Fine, fine too, Miriam. So, Miriam, tell me, Miriam, how was your day today?
I got to my job, and yeah, the things in my job, came back to my house.
Very good. Okay, okay, Miriam. And Miriam, tell me, what is the weather like today?
No, exactly with yesterday, like yesterday.
Very good.
Maybe, yeah. How do you say pasable?
Ah, bearable, tolerable, bearable, bearable. Bearable. Okay, bien, very good. Mira, and what about your breakfast? What do you have for breakfast today?
For breakfast, the yogurt.
Very good.
Yeah. So yogurt.
Okay. What about for lunch?
For lunch, some rice and how do you say rajas con pollo?
Chili chunks with chicken. Chili chunks with chicken.
With chicken.
Okay, delicious, Miriam. Very good. Mira, and what do you drink with that? Soda, water?
Water.
Water. Very good. Mira, do you like to drink cold water?
Oh yeah, it's my favorite in Monterrey.
Very good, Mira, very good. Okay, Mira, very good, okay, 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 good. Excellent, Mira, very good. Okay, man, so I'm going to share the link to the bowl with you, okay, in a minute. And look at this, it's going to be like this, okay? This one, okay. Okay, there, okay. Okay. Okay, and it's coming. Obviously, today is June 6, 2024. Grammar review, okay. We were here yesterday, okay. So I will read again, okay. We have several tenses, okay, the tenses that we have already practiced so far, and we have the usage, for example, simple present, habitual actions, routines, general thoughts, scheduled future events. Present continuous is used for ongoing actions happening now, temporary situations, and future arrangements. Present perfect simple, experiences or completed actions with a connection to the present, recent changes or new situations, and repeated actions up to the present. Present perfect continuous is used for ongoing actions that started in the past and are still continuing, emphasis on the duration of an activity. Simple past, completed actions or events in the past habits or routines, narrating a series of past events. Past continuous, ongoing actions or background events in the past, interrupted past actions, descriptions of past situations. For example, I will hear some sentences. Simple present, I go to work every day. Present continuous, I am working on a project right now. Present perfect simple, I have visited Spain several times. Present perfect continuous, I have been studying for the exam all week. Simple past, I went to the movies last night. And past continuous, I was reading a book when you called, okay? The key differences are the focus on habitual general actions versus ongoing temporary actions, and the connection to the present versus the past, okay? Okay, man, here, please write an example for each of them. For example, I wrote here yesterday, I go to work from Monday to Friday, okay? That is for simple present. Okay, please write 1 minute for simple present and one for the others, please, here.
Yes.
Very good. Okay, man. I return, man. There is someone at the door. Okay. I return in a minute. Okay. Wait for me. Okay.
Yes.
Very good. So let's say this. I go to work from Monday to Friday, and then I'm taking my English class. Okay. She has moved to Monterrey. Very good. She has been working. Okay, in the night or week. Good. Miriam, please, the next day.
They went to cinema yesterday.
Good.
And she was doing chores when her baby cried.
Very good. Excellent. Good, Miriam. Okay. Okay. Let's see what the book says. Okay, it says grammar, simple and continuous verbs. Okay, it says simple verbs are for completed actions, okay, or permanent situations. For example, present. What kind of music do you listen to? I love Latin music. I listen to it a lot. Present perfect. Have you ever lived in another country? No, I can never live anywhere else. Past. What did you do for your last birthday? I went home and had a big party. Continuous verbs are for ongoing actions or temporary situations. Pino, can you please read what?
What kind of music are you listening to currently? I am listening to a lot of Latin jazz right now.
Good.
How long have you been living here? I've been living here for 5 years. What were you doing at this time yesterday? I was sitting on a bus.
Very good, man. Okay, now let's practice. Remember, here, man, this activity is a combination of all of these verb tenses, okay? So the key is the context of the conversation. Okay? For example, I will read. Complete conversations use the simple or continuous form of the verb in the present perfect or past. Sometimes more than one answer is possible, then practice. For example, what have you been doing for fun lately? Well, I take boxing classes for the past few months. It's a lot of fun and I get in pretty good shape. Number two, who is the most interesting person you know? Well, I think my best friend is interesting. She lived in Europe for 3 years when she grew up. Number three, you ever meet anyone famous? No, but last year I see a TV star on the street. We both wait in line for ice cream. Trivia number four, when?
When you last exercise? Actually, I not exercise in months. I'm really busy at work, so I haven't had time.
Good.
Five.
What
you do for a living? Actually, I right now, when I'm not work, I look for a job for 6 months, but I not find anything yet.
For example, it says, what have you been doing for fun lately? Well, I have been taking. I have been taking. Okay. Okay, can you please continue, please? Good. Very good. Very good. I have been getting pretty good. Perfect. Good, Miriam. Good. Good. Remember, you have to pay attention to the context of the conversation, okay?
no, es el pasado. El pasado de grow es grew, ¿no?
Grew, exactly, mira, very good. Grew. Ale, mira, here it says, for 3 years. Dime, that means it's an indicator of present perfect. Ella ha vivido en Europa por 3 años. Very good. Y ya decimos cuando ella creció. Okay. Very good. Very good. Very good.
Great. Does anybody have? I.
Okay, you have it. Which number that you I? Ah, okay, man. We have to use the bed, no? It's instead of watches. See, no. Exactly, it's very good. Deme, it says in months. In months. In months is also an indicator for present perfect, no? No he ejercitado, no he hecho ejercicio en meses. Very good. I can hear this. Last. Ah, sorry. It says last. Last is an indicator for simple past.
Okay.
Okay. Dígase, ¿cuándo fue la última vez que ejercitaste?
Ay, ¿qué está haciendo?
¿No? ¿Cuándo fue la última vez que te ejercitaste?
Quería ya, no es cierto, quería estar bien.
Very good, mira, good, mira, good. Excelente, mira, good, 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 good. Very good. Good.
Necesito el iPad.
Very good.
It's a regular verb, Luke?
Exactly, it's a regular verb, yes. Found. Found, okay, found. Very good. Okay. Excellent, Miriam. Very good. Well done. Okay. Okay, so Miriam. I have another A, you have another B. Okay, it says, what have you been doing for fun lately?
Well, I have been taking kickboxing classes for the past few months. It's a lot of fun, and I have been getting in good shape.
Okay. Who is the most interesting person you know?
Well, I think my best friend is interesting. She has lived in Europe for 3 years when she grew up.
Very good. Have you ever met anyone famous?
No, but last year I saw a TV star on the streets. We have been both wait in line for ice cream.
The question is not, but last year I saw a TV star on the street. We were both waiting, para que diga, ambos estábamos esperando, formados para el lado. Okay, good. When did you last exercise?
Actually, I haven't done exercise in months. I have been really busy at work, so I haven't had time.
Good. What are you doing for a living?
Actually, I am not working right now. I have looked for a job for 6 months, but I haven't found anything yet.
Excellent, Miriam. Good, Miriam. Very good. Okay. So let's see extra practice. A simple and continuous verb review. It's complete the questions. Okay. Use the correct forms of the verbs given. I will read it. It says, what were you doing at this time last week? You play a sport last weekend? What kind of music you like nowadays? How long you know your best friend? Who do you usually spend time with on weekends? How often you go to the movies? You travel somewhere interesting on your last vacation? How long you learn English? For example, here, I sport last weekend. This is an indicator for simple past. So it's like, did you play? Good. I sport last weekend. Okay, please continue, please. Very good.
No way, this is just todos días, ¿no?
Exactly, no way, this is very good, yes. Exactly, Miriam, very good.
¿Si es liking o es con E? ¿Es así? No.
I don't know. También es in simple present. ¿Qué tipo de música te gusta estos días? ¿O actualmente?
Ok. Está bien.
Very much. So let's see. Very good. Let's see. Very good. Wait a minute. Okay. Okay. So let me share the screen. Very good. Okay. Did you play guitar? Yes. Do you like this? Jimena, how long is yours for present perfect? How long have you known this? Okay.
Pero que no nada más soy present.
How long have you known? Dice, ¿hace cuánto? Literalmente dice, ¿hace cuánto has conocido? No, realmente, ¿hace cuánto tiempo conoces? Is on weekends, okay. Who, do you, is simple present. Who do you usually spend time on weekends? Often you go to movies? Puede ser. Very good. Did you travel somewhere in your vacation? Very good. Aquí igual, mira. How long? Igual aquí. Have you learned English? Very good. I mean, I will read the phrase and you read the sentences. What were you doing at this time last week? Number two.
Did you play a sport last weekend?
What kind of music do you like nowadays?
How long have you known your best friend?
Good. Who do you usually spend time with on weekends?
And how often did you go to the movies?
Good. Did you travel somewhere interesting on your last vacation?
How long have you learned English?
Very good. Okay, so let's do another activity. Okay, I'm going to paste it here, okay? Also, to reinforce this grammar. Okay, so it's there. Very good. Yeah. Okay, is this one? Okay. Okay, good. Let's see. Very good. Very good. Okay, there it goes. Okay, for example, okay, I'm going to share the screen, okay? So here's also a combination of all these verb tenses, okay? So once again, you have to pay attention to the idea, okay, for example. She often listens to music. They watch TV at the moment. Yesterday, I see a lion in the zoo. I read an interesting book. At this time yesterday, they run in the park. Generally, I live in Poland, but this week, I stay with my friend in Paris. They passed all their exams last week. I sleep all day yesterday. Someone is still... Okay, I cannot see, okay? She never eats sweets. He do his homework when someone came in, they get fatter. My mom go to work by bus every day. Okay, my friends, let's answer from 1 to 13. For example, she often listen to me. This is obviously indicator of simple present. He says, she often listens to music, okay? She often listens to music. Okay, when you press on number 2 to number 13, please. Okay, good.
Wait a minute, teacher.
Look at this.
Is it talking on the computer?
Exactly, good. Very good.
No.
Okay, mira. Exactly. Good, mira. Good, good. Very good. Very good.
Pero si es tú, entonces sería más, ¿no?
No, no, it's good, man. Yes, generally I live in Poland, but this week I am staying, yes, it's good, with my friend in Paris.
That's been awesome.
Very good. Good.
Yes, thank you.
Good. There, mira, ahí dice, alguien roba mi bicicleta. That means that is an everyday action. Then you have to say, alguien se robó mi bicicleta, or alguien se ha robado mi bicicleta. Exactly. Alguien se ha robado mi bicicleta. No sabes en qué momento pasó, pero pues ya se lo llevaron, ¿no?
Sí.
Very good. When someone came in, in the past, no, es when someone, cuando alguien entró, very good.
They get fatter,
exactamente, or maybe. Ellos se están poniendo más gordos. Ellos se están poniendo o volviéndose más gordos.
They get fatter.
Exactly. Very good, 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 good. Goes good, Mina. Okay, I will read the next. Says, the students just break a window. My brother fly to New York tomorrow. I will tell you when I know something more. Water boil at 100 degrees Celsius. When I was younger, I be so small. Tom usually get up at 7. At the moment, we study English grammar. They come a few days ago. What you do now? Where you sleep last night? Who you meet tomorrow? Why she cry every day? You like football? Okay, the students just break a window. Super easy. Here is past. The students just broke a window. Okay, just broke a window. Okay, we will continue with us, please. Very good. In singular, miren, in singular. It says my brother, it says mi hermano.
Ah, cierto.
Exactly. Exactly, he's flying. Very good, very good. Good.
I will tell you when I know.
When I know, very good.
Water boil?
Boils, interpreta, ¿no? Water boils, good.
I was so small.
Very good.
Tom, let's go.
Good.
At the moment, we are improving English grammar.
Good.
They came.
Very good. They came. Good.
What will be doing?
Ah, de ver, ya soy. ¿Qué estás haciendo ahorita? Exactly. What are you doing? What are you doing? Exactly, Milan. What are you doing now? Good.
Where do you sleep?
Very good. Good.
Who are you meeting tomorrow?
Very good.
Why do you keep right?
Excellent. Exactly, in the future. Okay, man. Okay, I will read the phrase and you read the sentence. She often listens to music.
They are watching TV at the moment.
Good. Yesterday I saw a lion in the zoo.
I am reading an interesting book.
Okay. At this time yesterday, they were running in the park.
Generally, I live in Poland, but this week I am staying with my friend in Paris.
Good. They passed all their exams last week.
I slept all day yesterday.
Someone has stolen my bike.
She never eats sweets.
Okay, he was doing his homework when someone came in.
They get fatter.
Good. My mom goes to work by bus every day.
The students just broke a window.
Good. My brother is flying to New York tomorrow.
I will tell you when I know something.
Good. Water boils at 100 degrees Celsius.
When I was younger, I was so small.
Good. Tom usually gets up at 7.
At the moment, we are studying English grammar.
They came a few days ago.
What are you doing now?
Very good. Where did you sleep last night?
Who are you meeting tomorrow?
Good. Why does she cry every day?
Do you like football?
Do you like football? Very good. Excellent. Okay, so let's continue with the book. Okay, that is good. Okay, it's here. Very good. Okay, I'm going to share the image. Okay. Okay, there it goes. Okay, man. Can you see the book? It says it's a long story. Can you see it?
No, teacher.
No.
Es que está grabado literalmente en la pantalla del compartido.
Ah, ¿te quedaste en el pizarrón?
Sí. Bueno, se quedó literalmente en lo primero que estábamos viendo.
Ah, ok. Entonces, todo lo que conectaste lo viste porque estás en el pizarrón.
Ajá.
Ok. Ok, me interesa ponerlo. Ok, let's. Okay, voy a ponerlo en el pizarrón también. Ahí va, bueno, ok. Ahí está. Espera. Perfecto. Ah, está aquí. Sí, puede ver en el pizarrón. Esto mira que dice It's a long story, está en el pizarrón. Dice Build the vocabulary and grammar, ¿sí lo puedes ver?
Sí.
Sí, ok, very good. Ok, there it goes, ok. Ok, so. Let's go. Okay. Good.
Page 4. Lesson B.
Si puedes, can you listen to it, Miriam? Can you hear it?
Escucha muy bajito.
Sorry?
No. It's a slow, the volume.
It's very low? Okay. So don't worry, okay.
And down.
Okay, don't worry. Let's read it. It says, so I am here and it says, lesson B, it's a long story. Build the vocabulary and grammar. Okay, it says, listen. Listen to Dan's story. Answer the questions. Where did Dan live before he moved to Seoul? Why did he want to go to South Korea? How did he get his job there? What did his new company offer him? Give me about Dan's story. He says, Dan Anderson was born in the USA. He's now living in South Korea. We ask him, how did you end up living in South Korea, sorry, in Seoul. Dan. Miriam, well, it's a long.
Ay, no.
Well,
it's a long story. Before I came here, I spent 3 years working for a small company in Tokyo. While I finished doing my master's in business, to be honest, I wasn't planning on leaving or anything, but one day I happened to be in the office and one of the salespeople was looking at job ads online. He knew I was considering going to South Korea someday. You see, my mother South Korea and I always been interested in the culture and everything. And anyway, he went over and said, Dan, this seems to be the perfect job for you. Check this out. I looked at at the art, and I remember thinking, should I bother to apply? But I decided to go for it, even though I didn't expect to get it, and to make it a long story short, I got the job. The company offered to transfer me to Seoul, and they agreed to pay for my Korean language lessons. I started working here 2 months later, and the rest is history. I mean, I miss living in Japan, but you can have it both ways. I guess, actually, I can't imagine living anywhere else now.
Very good, man. Okay, for example, let's see new words, okay? For example, this one, for example, that's a person, okay? I mean, there's in the culture. Dígame, ¿cuál es mi lean over? Lean over. ¿Cuál es mi lean over? Lean over. ¿Sabéis de paz? ¿Sabéis de paz? The present is... lean over. That is the present. The obviously is a regular verb. The past is leaned over. Es que puede correr, Miriam. Lean over, Miriam. Lean over es recargarse sobre, okay, apoyarse sobre
un objeto o algo, ¿no?
Very good, exactly. Very good. Lean over, okay. Another is, what is this one? Even tough. Wait a minute, even tough.
No, I don't know.
Even tough, ¿saben? ¿Copieron? Even tough es a pesar de eso. Even tough, okay. Okay, I guess. What do you mean? I guess.
Dijimos que era como suponiendo o algo así.
I guess. Yo creo. Si quieres poner por ahí, yo creo, yo supongo. Okay. I guess. Yo creo, yo supongo. Very good, man.
Bueno,
así me la sé. Very good. Okay. Vamos a hacer. Espera. Vamos a hacer un cambio. A ver si con el cambio ya puedes escucharlo. Si no, voy a terminar un poquito. Okay. Okay. Let's see. Okay, mira, in the meantime, Miriam, please tell me, what are you going to do after class, Miriam?
Maybe I sleep.
Okay. Okay. So you are tired, Miriam.
Yes, I am tired, but I don't know because I feel.
Yes.
I sleep good. I could sleep so. But I don't know.
Okay. I mean, and how is your sleeping, Miriam? Is your sleeping good, bad? Interrupted, I don't know.
But I'm bad. Well, it's good because the climate is indispensable for my break, for my sleep. Because I can't sleep if I don't, let's say, tapada.
Okay. I can't sleep. I can't sleep covered.
So the climate in my room is very, very cold. So I can't sleep because I can't cover. So.
Oh, mira, that is difficult, man. Mira,
yes.
Do you sleep with air conditioner all night on?
No, all night, but maybe the middle.
Okay. Well, exactly, yes.
And obviously you have to wake up and turn off the air conditioner, right?
Yes.
Okay, Miriam, I see. Okay. Yeah, Miriam, sleeping in hot weather is difficult. Why? Because number one is super uncomfortable. And number two, you have to wake up. For you, you have to wake up in order to turn off the air conditioner, Miriam. Okay, Miriam, very good. Okay, Miriam, so this topic, Miriam, we have already studied this topic from your university. I remember that we studied this one, but now we're going to study deeper. Okay, vamos a estudiarlo con más profundidad, okay. There it goes, Miriam. Okay, I'm going to share the screen. Wait a minute. Okay, there it goes. The topic is like this, okay? The topic is called bear patterns, okay? What is patterns? Es estructuras, formas verbales, okay? In English, medium, there are seven bear patterns, okay? Which are the basic ones. One of them is this one, medium. Verb plus ing. If this verb are followed by another verb, the structure is verb plus ing. For example, admit, adore, allow, avoid, can stand, carry on, consider, deny, delay, don't mind, enjoy, fancy, finish, give up, imagine, involve, keep on, postpone, practice, put off, recommend, risk and suggest. Okay, maybe please read it for me, please. Admit,
adore, allow, avoid, can stand, carry on, consider, deny, delay, deny, enjoy, fancy, finish, give up, imagine, involve, postpone, practice, put out, recommend,
risk,
suggest.
Very good, okay. I'm going to copy these verbs for you, okay? And I'm going to share them with you on WhatsApp. Can you access your OneNote, Miriam? Do you have access to your OneNote?
Today, no, because I forget my notebook in the writing, my choreo, and the...
I don't know. I mean your OneNote. Remember, OneNote is part of the Microsoft Family, and on
yes.
OneNote.
Por eso no puedo entrar porque se me olvidó mi contraseña y mi correo y los tengo en la otra.
Okay.
Pero lo olvidé en el trabajo.
Don't worry. Espera. I have the solution for that. I'm going to give you the. Remember, I have the password, okay, and the email for your OneNote. Okay, wait a minute, okay? And I'm going to share it to you by WhatsApp. Wait a minute, very good. Okay. Very good. So, man, your plan is to sleep all night, Miriam. Miriam, do you wake up during the night? I mean, for example, do you wake up to drink water? I don't know, because you listen to noise and you wake up, or do you sleep deeply? Remember, deeply, profundamente.
I sleep.
What, Miriam?
I go to sleep profundamente.
Deeply.
I deeply sleep.
Exactly, good, very good, okay.
But for example, and 4 or 5 o'clock,
good.
I wake up, but my organs,
my body asks me.
My body asks me, the pee.
To go to the toilet, okay? To go to the toilet. Very good, man. It happens to me the same, man. And for me, it's horrible, because I stop sleeping. I stop to sleep, and then I go to the bathroom, okay? For me, that is terrible, man, okay? Okay, man. There you have, man, the user and the password for your account, okay? And there you have the access. The link which says office.com, that is the access to go into your account, okay? And, okay, first, try to access OneNote, and then you will tell me if you are able or not. If you cannot, don't worry, I will help you, okay?
Wait a minute, because my the internet is slow.
Okay.
Exacto.
Y ahí adentro ya puedes acceder a tu OneNote, ¿no? Very good, man. Please paste on OneNote. Paste the photo that I send you, okay? And I'm going to tell you the verbs, okay, in Spanish, okay? Maybe you know most of them, I'm sure you know most of them. In case not, okay, don't worry. Okay, we will re-study them, okay? Okay, bien, very good. For example, the first one, I'm going to say that in Spanish. Admit, obviously, is admitir. Okay. Adorar o gustar mucho. Okay. Hello. Permitir. Avoid. Evitar.
A ver, avoid y permitir, ¿verdad?
Exacto. Allow, permitir. Allow, permitir. Avoid. Evitar. Can't stand. Can't stand, no poder tolerar, no poder soportar. Carry on, continuar. Consider, suprise, considerar. Deny, fíjate, nunca es deny, es deny. Rehusarse, negarse. Delay, retrasar. Delay, retrasar. Don't mind, no molestar, no importar, en el sentido de que no te molesta hacer algo o no te molesta comer algo. Que no te importa hacer algo, no te importa comer algo, por ejemplo. Okay, enjoy, disfrutar. Fancy es tener ganas, tener antojo de.
Y también se maneja como un adjetivo de niña fresa, ¿no?
Exacto, very good. Good, miren, exacto, también es un adjetivo. Very good. Good, miren, good. Finish, terminar. Give up, rendirse. Give up, rendirse. Imagine, imaginar. Involve, involucrarse, involucrarse. Keep, mantener, conservar. Keep on es igual que este es continuar, seguir, continuar, seguir. Postpone, postpone, posponer. Postpone, posponer. Practice, obviously practice, practicar. Put off, put off es lo mismo, ok. Posponer. Recommend, recommend, recomendar. Risk, arriesgar. Y suggest, sugerir. For example, mira, here I wrote, he avoided writing the test. Keep smiling. Did you enjoy reading the book? He denied stealing the purse. Pero mira, I don't mind.
I don't mind helping you. He's often not always walking in this house. He recommends stay in that hotel.
So, the rule, okay? The rule after these verbs, when we combine them with other verbs, the second verb must go with ing. Always, all the time, okay? Look at the category number two. Verb plus two plus infinitive. For example, I will read this as afford, agree, allow, appear, arrange, ask, attempt, choose, dare, decide, expect, fail, forget, help, hope, learn, manage, offer, plan, pretend, promise, refuse, seem, tend, threaten, want, and would like to. So after this verb, meaning always you need to write two plus infinitive, okay? Okay, I will tag with them in Spanish, okay? Afford. Afford is poder pagar. Este usualmente se combina con así, mira. Usualmente lo vas a encontrar can afford o el negativo can afford. Okay, es puedo pagar o no puedo pagar, okay? Okay, agree. Agree es estar de acuerdo. Es por ahí, agree, estar de acuerdo. Allow, permitir. Allow, permitir. Appear, appear, aparecer. Appear, aparecer. Arrange, arrange, acordar. Ponerse de acuerdo, acordar, ponerse de acuerdo. Ask, pedir. O también puede ser preguntar. Attempt, intentar. Attempt.
Attempt,
intentar.
Ask es preguntar, ¿no?
Ask, preguntar. Attempt, intentar. Choose, seleccionar, escoger. Dare, atreverse. Dare, atreverse. Decide, decidir. Expect, esperar. Fail, fallar. Forget, olvidar. Help, ayudar. Hope, también hope es esperar en cuanto a esperanza. Learn, aprender. Manage, arreglar. ponerse de acuerdo, manage, arreglar. O también puede ser, miren, otro significado puede ser enfrentar. Manage, enfrentar. Offer, ofrecer. Plan, planear. Pretend, pretender. Fingir. Promise, prometer. Refuse, rehusarse, negarse. Seem, parecer. Seem, parecer. Parecer, ajá.
¿De qué se llama? ¿Parecerse o parecer?
Ah, no, no. Parece después. Ah, parece que estás en un problema. Parece que tenemos que resolver algo, ¿no? Parecer, ok. Tend. Tender, en el sentido de que tiene tendencia a algo. Tend, tender, pero ahí ponle en la nota, tener tendencia a algo. No de tender la ropa, no, no, sino de tener tendencia a algo. Threaten, amenazar. Threaten, amenazar. Want, querer. Y would like to, gustaría. Look at my example. She says, I can't afford to go on holiday. She has decided to give up her job. It seems to be a nice day. Miren, he agreed
to lend me some money. You are not allowed to smoke here.
Very good, man. Very good. Okay, man. Now, please, man, please choose four verbs for the fifth category. Four, and then choose four verbs from the second category, and please write four examples. For example, for each category. For example, I'm going to use, for example, avoid. For example, I can say, for example, I avoid, okay, staying up late. ¿Qué dirá ahí? Mira, ¿qué dice eso? Mira, I avoid staying up late. ¿Qué es eso? Mira, I avoid.
Evito quedarme más tarde.
Casi, casi, miren. Estoy segundo, mira. Stay up late, todo junto. La forma simple es esta, mira, sí. Ahí te la pongo. Stay up late. Eso, miren, es un phrasal verb de tres palabras, ¿ok? Stay up late es desvelarse, miren. Stay up late, desvelarse. So, I avoid staying up late, evito desvelarme. ¿Sí? Tenemos uno con, por ejemplo, con to, for example, you can say, con allow, for example. My parents allow me to go, okay, to the park. My parents allow me to go to the park. Mis padres me permiten, me da permiso de ir al parque. Okay, please choose four verbs, okay, for ing and four verbs with to, and please write four sentences, okay. Remember, man, they are verbs. You can write them in present, remember, with all of these time markers, okay. You can write them in simple present, present continuous, present perfect simple, present perfect continuous, simple past, or past continuous, okay. Why? Because all of them are verbs, and verbs, obviously, they can be conjugated in any tense, okay.
¿Cuántos me dijo?
Four for ing and four for to. Okay. Remember, use any verb tense you want to. Okay.
Teacher, ¿puedo yo decir que dice mamá que todo? ¿Think? No.
¿Pedir? ¿Pedir? Ah, sí. ¿Pedir? Axford. Axford. Pedir. Axford. Very good. Very good. Very good. She affords, she affords to, with S, she affords to. Okay.
Okay.
She affords to, very good. Ella puede pagar, ella puede pagar, o ella paga, puede bien, quedarse en un hotel de lujo. Very good. Very good, yes, good, 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 yes, perfect, good, good. Fails, my friend fails. To take the test, to take the test. Very good.
Who is writing neighborhood?
A neighbor offers. A neighbor offers. Good. Very good. Okay, man. I will read the first and you read the second. It says, she admits walking alone last night.
My assessor considered writing recommendation for scholarship.
For scholarship. Very good. I finished working late on Monday.
I risk asking for fast food for his home.
Very good. She affords to stay in Germany.
My friend fails to take the test.
Very good. A neighbor offers to do chores.
I hope to pass my test.
Very good, Miriam. Very good. Okay. So let me bring and the next part for these verbs. Very good. Excellent. Okay. Just a bring. There it goes. Okay, let's put it here and put it down here. Very good. It's there. Okay. Okay, I'm going to share them. Okay, there it goes. Okay, here then we have another category, which is verb plus object plus to plus infinitive. Okay, for example, we have advise, allow, ask, beg, encourage, expect, force, invite, order, permit, persuade, recommend, remind, teach, tell, want, warn, would like. For example, you could say, they invited us to stay in their house. She told me to come on time. They asked us not to make such noise, okay? También te lo voy a poner en el WhatsApp para que lo tengas. Espera, very good. There it goes. There it is, okay. Good, Miriam. Good. You can take it there to your OneNote, okay? Very good. Okay. And also this one too. Okay. There it goes. Okay. Also that part, also please paste it there on OneNote, okay? Very good. Okay, so I will tell you in Spanish, okay, for part three, which is verb plus object plus to plus infinitive, okay? Okay, in Spanish, maybe advice, okay? There you go. Aconsejar, recomendar. Tenemos nuevamente allow, fíjate que allow ya pertenece a dos categorías. Allow, eso ya lo sabes, permitir. Tenemos nuevamente ask, okay? Ask. Preguntar, okay. Beg, rogar, encourage, animar, expect, también ya tenemos en otra categoría, expect, esperar, force,
animar, después de animar, ¿qué era?
Expect, esperar. Expect, esperar. Force, forzar, obligar. Invite, invitar. Order, ordenar. Permit, permitir. Persuade, persuadir, recommend, recomendar, remind, remind, recordar, obviously teach, enseñar, tell, decir, okay, want, ya tenemos want, querer o desear, warn, warn, advertir, y would like es igual, gustaría, okay. And look at the pattern, is they invited us to stay in their house. Tenemos el verbo, tenemos un pronombre de objeto, y el segundo verbo con tú. She told me to come on time. Tenemos el verbo, un pronombre de objeto, y el segundo verbo con tú. They asked us not to make such a noise. Tenemos el verbo, sí, tenemos un pronombre de objeto, y el negativo, en este caso el negativo, not to. Fíjate cómo es negativo en el segundo verbo, not to make such noise. Ok, okay, very good. Ok. Ah, es bueno. Mira, will you be reading for me, please? Advice.
Advice, allow us that encourage is efforts invite.
Es encourage, encourage.
Encourages efforts invite order permit persuade good. Recommend remind teach tell one warn will
like. Very good. Okay. Here it is. Another category. Verb plus ing plus two infinitive with no change. Sorry, no change in meaning. For example, begin, continue, intend, and start. For example, you can say, for example, it started to rain, it started raining. Or for example, you can say, mira, for example, I begin to work, or I begin working. Y es exactamente lo mismo. No hay cambio de significado. Ok. Vamos a mirar. Category 5. Verb plus object plus infinitive. No to in the structure. For example, help, let, and make. For example, let me show you. The news made her cry. I'll help you do it. Es decir, esos verbos se combinan con otros verbos, pero en la forma simple. No requieren to. Y no requiere ing. Oye, okay, pues, I will say in Spanish. Begin, mira. Begin, pone para mí, begin, iniciar, empezar, comenzar. Continue, continuar. Intent, ok. Intentar. Start, empezar, comenzar. Help, ayudar. Let, permitir. Y make, hacer. Fíjate que este verbo, miran, este verbo help, también es posible que lo encuentres así, mira, por ejemplo. I help my mother to cook. Sorry. I help my mother to cook. Pero también puede ser así, mira. I help my mother cook. Es acepta ambos, miren. Acepta con tú o acepta en la forma simple. Si quieres, ponle por ahí para el ejemplo de help, para que lo tengas también. Entonces te lo voy a poner aquí. Ahí lo voy a poner. Very good.
O sea, pues, ¿puedes
ponerlo? Exactamente. Lo puedes poner con tú o en la forma simple. Grammatically, puedo estar correcto, ¿ok? Grammatically, puedo estar correcto.
Ok, yes.
Ok. Oye, mira, so, bien, now, miren, please, the same. Choose four verbs here, and please choose two verbs for category four, and two verbs for category five, and write sentences. For example, permit. or persuade. For example, you can say, she persuaded me to buy more food. She persuaded me to buy more food. Remember bien the pattern. Recuerda bien de cada verbo la estructura que tiene que seguir, ¿ok? Pero son for from category 3, two from category 4, and two from category 5, ¿ok? Very good.
¿Cómo se pone? We is them, no, no, no.
Muy bien. Muy bien, is they. They help only, they help.
Así sí.
They help. They help us. They help us do our project. They help us. Very good. Very good.
But I can you remember what did you say? Hasta tarde.
Yes. Until late. Until late. Okay, so let's check. It says, I want you to walk on the street. And she invites him to go out at a restaurant. My sister teaches me, remember, still present, teaches me to make up. Very good. I would like you to buy a book. Very good, okay. I continue doing my homework. He starts, he's a third person, he starts to do exercise. They help us do our project. My mom let him go out. Again, I will read the phrase and you're reading a second. It says, I want you to walk on the street.
She invites him to go out at a restaurant.
My sister teaches me to make up.
I would like you to buy a book.
Very good. He said, I continue doing my homework.
He starts to do exercise.
Good. They help us do our project.
My mom let him go out with friends until
then. Very good, Miriam. Very good. Okay, Miriam. Let's play. Okay, very good. Let me.
Teacher.
Yes.
Can I go to the restroom, board?
Yes, of course.
I have a problem. The restroom is the down. Is the first floor.
Okay.
But I don't
serve
well.
Yes, Miriam, go. Don't worry. I will wait for you. Don't worry. Déjame. I'm back. Very good. Okay, man. So there, man, I already shared a link with the quizzes. Okay, let's play it. Okay, very good. There you are. Very good, man. Very good. Okay, so let's start. Okay. Very good. Okay, here the plan is to practice ing and to, okay? Yeah. Excellent, man. Very good. So let's see. Let's see the answers. Okay, very good. Okay, so question five. Okay, let's see question five. I can't help. Remember, eating. Remember, eating. I can't help eating. Okay. Chocolate when I am stressed. Okay. Very good. Question 7, okay. Jason expects to go with Sally to the concert. Very good, very good. Question 10, okay. We hope to finish school early today. Very good. This is I miss living, miss with ing. I miss living in London. Very good. Question 12. Good. I enjoy seeing them again. Very good. Okay. And question 19. Do you mind if I sit here? Do you mind if I sit here? Remember, here is first conditional, okay? O conditional zero. ¿Le molesta si me siento aquí? Do you mind if I sit here? Very good. Excellent, Miriam. Generally, it's good, Miriam. Excellent, Miriam. Good, Miriam. Okay, Miriam. So let's stop here, Miriam. See you next class, okay? Homework, Miriam. Homework is to study and memorize the five categories we were studying today, okay?
Okay.
Okay, Miriam. Book four, Miriam. Book four is more demanding, okay? As you said, book four is one of the last books that we have, okay? So memorize those verses, okay? Okay, Mina. So thank you very much, Mina. Have a great night. May I see you in the class. Thank you very much. Thank you. Bye-bye. Night-night. Thank you.
Bye.
Night-night. Thank you very much. Thank you.